The alchemy of a lightsaber was a complicated one. At the weapon's core is a mineral known as a kyber crystal, and it was a living, breathing stone. What visions would it present to its user? On a mission to create his own signature saber, Darth Vader had stalked a Jedi across the galaxy. A Sith needed to take a lightsaber from his enemies and turn it red. Vader had completed the first part. Now he was headed to the volcanic planet of Mustafar, where he had just been defeated a few weeks prior to complete his mission. The cave Vader wandered through after setting his vehicle down on the erupting surface echoed with secrets of the Sith. It was a truly evil place he was entering. He approached a tabletop, surrounded by nothing except for Sith illustrations all across the walls around it. Without noting his surroundings, Vader remained totally focused on the task at hand. As he knelt before the tabletop and began dismantling the once Jedi weapon, the crystal within glowed an electric green color. But for Vader, the red tint on his mask lenses meant all he could see was a stone of brown hue. It was metaphorical. Not only could he not see physically the goodness within it, he was blinded by the anger and hatred facilitated in him by Darth Sidious. As Vader watched the crystal, it started to glow an even more intense white beam. He knew he was about to witness something he could not let get to him. Having been warned by his master about the light side influence and vitality of Jedi-influenced kyber crystals, Vader took a step back, reached out his arms, preparing to use his dark side force powers if needed. He levitated the crystal as the beam it emitted grew in intensity. An electric green hue began to fill the room, momentarily erasing the Sith illustrations on the walls with its great power. The beam the stone emitted soon developed into a powerful, force-fueled explosion of light that thrust Vader across the cave. Crushed up against the stone Sith-illustrated wall, the Sith Lord's staunch demeanor had turned to one of awe and shock.
What have I done?
With parts of his armor having been ripped off his body, exposing one of his eyes and part of his leg, Vader stumbled back over to the tabletop. Holding the crystal up to the light, he reinstalled it in the lightsaber's hilt, reconstructing the Jedi weapon. The Sith illustrations around him all but disappeared, and a light green hue filled the cave as Vader exited with the Jedi weapon in tow and intact. Suddenly, the Sith found himself before his master, high above the sprawling city of Coruscant in his office. Having come back from his lightsaber creating mission, Sidious demanded to see the blade, which he expected to be boasting a Sith crimson color. When Vader brandished his Jedi green saber, Sidious realized that he had failed in his training, assuming his apprentice had chosen the side of good. Suddenly, the Dark Lord ejected from his seat and shot himself at Vader with his Sith lightsaber in hand.
So be it, my friend.
Vader, having expected this, knowing the volatile and truly evil nature of his master, was quick to defend with his new saber, indicating that he was fighting the side of the good. Sidious taunted his apprentice as he violently swung his crimson saber, but Vader was just too strong. Quickly dodging and evading any swipe, Vader delivered a crushing slice across his master's body, finally knocking him to the ground. All the terror Sidious once symbolized was gone, as his former apprentice slipped out of the office. Then Vader found himself in a totally different environment. He saw his former Jedi master, Obi-Wan Kenobi, sitting peacefully among a beautiful field, complete with blooming flowers and celestial views. It was a very stark contrast to the previous place Vader was in. However, as he approached his old friend, Vader was greeted with more confrontation. Kenobi brandished his lightsaber, ready for combat against his now evil friend. But Vader didn't want any violence. He slowly removed his helmet and knelt before his former master, effectively reverting back to Anakin Skywalker, the once promising Jedi Knight. However, Obi-Wan didn't see it that way. With his lightsaber still ablaze, all Kenobi saw was the great Lord of the Sith and an evil member of the dark side, and swung his weapon down to deliver a fatal blow to the long-lost friend. But something miraculous happened. Just as the lightsaber blade was about to reach Vader's head, it suddenly fizzled out. Skywalker had been saved. In shock, he stared at Obi-Wan until he was no longer there, and found himself back in the cave on Mustafar, in exactly the same position he was before. He had just been subject to the Kyber Crystal's vision of the future, a future that turned him away from the Sith and toward the light, for better or worse. Vader was still in the midst of his Sith training. This meant he still had the potential to be swayed back to the Jedi with enough motivation. The Kyber Crystal and the Jedi's lightsaber could feel this battle inside him, between good and evil. Like him, it was incredibly strong with the Force. Yet it was exactly this strength that was causing the torture inside. the light on one side, and Darth Sidious desperately tempting him toward the dark side in a constant barrage of teaching, lies, and degradation on the other. Either way, Anakin Skywalker was now a name getting further and further away from memory, or reality. Vader was rewriting his own history, and ultimately, wasn't going to let the influence of the Jedi Kyber Crystal stop him.